Well, earlier this year, Vonda Malone became the first female mayor to be elected to the Torres Shire Council in the Torres Strait. But while it's a milestone for women in the Torres Strait, her motivation to achieve greatness is driven by her strong upbringing and determination to make a difference for her family and community. Rachael Hocking has the story.
Above Cape York, a collection of islands make up the tip of our country. Among them lies Thursday Island, the central hub of the Torres Strait. It's home to about 2,500 people, including Vonda Malone.
I became the first female mayor for the Torres Shire Council in the Torres Strait.
She's been in the job just 3 months, but she already looks like a natural.
With TI, I think we need to embrace the fact that we have such a diverse and rich culture and that we can live in harmony together. We need to make sure that our community members have safe communities, have places where we're trying to encourage people to maintain good health and well-being. So that's the type of things that I would like to push.
Vonda has a big vision for Thursday Island and the wider Torres Strait. But as the first female to get here, her path has been longer than most.
So I knew I was going to be doing something different, but not the first. And I think that as I went along, I seemed to be the first, particularly being a female as well, breaking those milestones in my life.
When she started school, well, I don't think she missed a day at school right through the whole lot of it to grade 12. She turned up every day. You couldn't get her to stop.
I was born here on TI, raised here, and just through my early childhood, fond memories of growing up at Back Beach. And it was always about the sea, always about fishing, swimming, and making our own entertainment, because in those days we didn't have TV or the luxury of phones and mobile phones, all those distractions that we have today. So childhood was all about being creative and enjoying the environment that we had.
Growing up, this was Vonda's world. Humble beginnings, rich with culture. But she knew there had to be more outside of the Torres Strait.
I think in that time we were like 10 or 20 years behind the rest of Australia. But it was very much strong island lifestyle of working and living with our extended families. Wow. And that's, I think, those principles of family I've kept right and through. Good
afternoon. But growing up wasn't always easy. When Vonda was a teenager, she learnt that the man who'd raised her wasn't her biological dad, and that her real father was Aboriginal and not from the Torres Strait.
That was a missing part of my life, and I needed to find that. So it was just a part of my life that I needed to understand better, and so that I could also pass that on to my daughter so she understood that important background. Up until then, it was always about the Torres Strait. And once understanding and connecting with a lot of people along the way, I felt I was really blessed because I have both Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander heritage. This is the post that they had in the Courier Mail at the time.
It's been a long road to get here. She's worked on Torres Strait treaty talks, travelled to the UN and back, and before she was 30, she was working for the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade in New Zealand.
So really having that separation and having that responsibility, being seen as, you know, the first Indigenous person to do it, it was a real steep learning curve.
At such a young age, the world was becoming her oyster. But instead of pursuing jobs across the world, Vonda returned home.
I returned after I lost my brother. I think it was part of my healing. I needed to return home, and I had lots of opportunities. I could have worked anywhere in the world after New Zealand, but I felt it was important that I'd be back home and support my family. So I guess in some ways sacrificed that, but I knew that I still wanted to be here and make a difference here at home.
So Vonda got stuck into working for local government organisations, But she had one more obstacle.
Women weren't in senior positions in the organisation, so I worked myself up the chain, I suppose, because of my internal drive and motivation. But you always had to be 10 times better than your male counterpart.
You are women and girls who have the ability to empower other women and girls.
It was a forum just like this which gave Vonda the push she needed to run for mayor.
Vonda Malone spent the last 23 years working for the government organisations and currently the executive director of primary healthcare with the Torres and Cape Hospital and Health Service. It's her second bid to become the Torres Shire mayor.
And in March this year, Vonda's island home did something it's never done before.
I, Vonda Lisa Malone, have been elected as mayor of the Torres Shire Council.
But she put every effort into getting there, you know what I mean? Educational-wise, school-wise, everything.
It was an unreal moment, and I think a lot of people were very, very happy that we came to that stage, and they felt accomplished, just as accomplished as I was on the day of making history.